This is what we call a ghost forest. We're right next to the Albemarle Sound here, and the water has been rising faster than this system has a time to migrate. As the trees die, they lose their bark, they lose the smaller branches, and they kind of look whitish from a distance, so they kind of look like ghosts. We know that right now where I'm standing, the shore used to be 80 feet from where the shore is right now. If I was to walk out there, you can see the last snag out there. It was probably a little bit farther than that, where the shore used to be, you know, probably around 1990s. So we've lost that amount of soil and that amount of carbon. We've lost it. Some of it might have gone down and it's buried in the bottom of the sound, and some of it might be up in the atmosphere. Once you have these snags in these ghost forests, what happens to the greenhouse gas emissions through these trees? We know that trees move gases up and down from the soils into the atmosphere when they're alive. And then what we wanted to know is what happens after they're dead, because those capillary, those cavities in the bark still stay there. So we're interested in understanding if those snags functioned as straws, facilitating the movement of gas into the atmosphere, or as corks, keeping the soils, the gases in the soil itself. So what we're saying now is that they kind of function as filtered straws, because they facilitate the movement of some gases, but they also help filter out some of the gases. These ghost forests are expanding, and they're expanding here in North Carolina, but they're also expanding in Georgia, South Carolina, really all over the Southeast. One of the solutions that we've been interested in is, okay, we're losing these wetlands here. Can we restore wetlands in other places to try to sequester more carbon, reduce greenhouse gas emissions, and also create habitat for birds or vegetation? We've found that by restoring these wetlands, the greenhouse gas emissions are reduced by about 50%. This is a citizen science station, and the idea is that people take pictures of the same spot over time and email it to us. And so this is an area that is gonna turn into a ghost forest. It's not there yet, but it's just kind of early on in that stage of turning into a ghost forest, and we wanna see, you know, how is it changing? I like studying ghost forests because they're a very clear indication that climate change is here, that climate change is happening, and that it's here and now.